Hello, Sakum. We were studying the anatomy of thoracic wall and we were at joints of thoracic wall. We've seen the manubriosternal joint in previous video, so we will jump to xiphisternal joint. Xiphisternal joint is between the xephoid process of the sternum and the body of the sternum. Xiphisternal joint is the secondary cartilaginous joint. That secondary cartilaginous joints are also called symphysis. They are found mostly in the midline of the body and they offer some movement. They are permanent joints that do not ossify with the age, but it is not a true secondary cartilaginous joint actually. It ossifies in some point of the age, in middle age mostly. However, the age in which it ossifies varies person to person. Xiphoid process is itself a cartilage. It is hyaline cartilage in the proximal portion and elastic cartilage in the distal portion. It gives attachment to the different abdominal muscles like diaphragm and rectus abdominis. There are two costovertebral joints. One joint is between the head of the rib and vertebra, and other joint is between neck of the rib and vertebra. So the joint between head of the rib and vertebra is called costocorporeal joint, and the joint between neck of the rib and vertebra is called costotransfer joint, because it is between the neck of the rib and transverse process of the vertebra. So there are two types of joints between the rib and vertebra. First we will talk about the costocorporeal or costovertebral joint. The ribs between 2nd to 9th articulate with two vertebral bodies. As you can see in this picture, the ribs between 2nd to 9th articulate with the two vertebral bodies. Each vertebral body have two demifacets. This is inferior demifacet and this is superior demifacet. So the rib will articulate with the superior demifacet of the corresponding vertebrae. Means if it is rib 2, it will articulate with the superior demifacet of the T2 and inferior demifacet of the vertebra immediately above it, means T1. So the rib between 2nd to 9th articulate with two vertebras, but the first rib articulates only with one vertebra, that is T1, and lowest three ribs also articulate with the vertebra that is corresponding to their number, only one vertebra. Means if it is rib 10, it will articulate only with T10, rib 11 articulate with T11, and rib 12 will articulate only T12. First rib and lower three ribs will articulate only one vertebral body, that is with their own corresponding number, and the rib from 2nd to 9th articulate with two vertebral bodies, and that was this joint, which is with the head of the rib and with the vertebral body. And this joint, that is costotransverse joint, it is absent in the rib 11 and 12. The costotransverse joint is absent in the rib 11 and 12. So rib 11 and 12 do not articulate with the transverse process of that vertebra. Then come the costocondral joint. Costocondral joints are between the ribs and costal cartilage that attaches them with the sternum. They are cartilaginous joint and offer very little movement. This costal cartilage is hyaline cartilage. Each rib has a cup-shaped depression plates with the costal cartilage. Then come the sternocostal joint. The first cartilage articulate with the manubrium, and this is a cartilaginous joint, and this first rib and manubrium joint offers no movement. From rib 2nd to 7th, the costal cartilage is articulated to the body of the sternum by synovial joints. So from 2nd to 7th, the body of the sternum and costal cartilage are articulating by the synovial joints. The costal cartilages of rib 8, 9, 10 articulate with one another, and these are also synovial joints. So all the costosternal joints and the costocostal joints are synovial joints. But the first costosternal joint, the joint between first rib and manubrium is not a synovial joint, it is a cartilaginous joint. And the cartilages of the rib 11 and 12 are embedded in the abdominal musculature. That is all for today. We will see muscles of thoracic wall in the next lecture. Till then, the Hafiz.